Hello students, now we have to see the topic of mechanism of polymerization. So this mechanism of polymerization we have to see in terms of particularly addition polymerization. And addition polymerization is nothing but the when the number of monomers, just those particular type of a monomer or a molecule which forms the polymer is called as a monomer. And whenever there is the same type of monomer, here there is a singly ethylene molecule is there. Number of ethylene molecules when added, there is a formation of polyethylene. So it is called as the addition polymerization. So what are the different conditions which are there? Here number of similar type of monomers are there. There is no any another reagent to add in it. Reaction can be initiated by such a light or heat or any simple type of catalyst. Then there must be unsaturation. To initiate the reaction, there must be unsaturation. And when this unsaturation is there, that second bond, which is a pi bond, it can be broken to form the free radicals on the different carbon, and it is already always ready to form the another bond with another molecule. Here we can see that this bond has been broken and formation of such a sites for the reaction. And when until we stop or terminate this reaction, it will be continued. So that's why it is called as a polyethylene. It has a very very high molecular weight, and whenever the very high molecular weights are there, it is called as a high polymer. So like that, it is an example of addition polymerization. Now we have to see, actually we can take the similar example of ethylene. Like that, there is an example of styrene. So when styrene undergoes the polymerization process, there is a formation of polystyrene, like that. So here we will see particularly the mechanism of free radical addition polymerization. So this mechanism of addition polymerization can be carried out by three different ways. That is the free radical addition polymerization, then second is the cationic addition polymerization and anionic addition polymerization. We have already seen in these different videos that how anionic addition polymerization is carried out, how cationic addition polymerization is carried out, and now we will see how free radical addition polymerization is carried out. So simply, whenever there is a, we have to go through that mechanism, there are mainly three steps. Number one, initiation, where to initiate the reaction. Number two, propagation, and number three, very important step, that is the termination. So like that, there are the three steps which are the main step to carry out the free radical addition polymerization. Now we will see first step, initiation. This initiation, now we can consider a particular molecule, or we can consider an ethylene molecule, which is a very very important example of the addition polymerization. So initiation, it can be carried out in the two different small steps. Like in first step, first of all, there is a formation of free radical. Whenever the reaction is carried out by free radical addition polymerization, there must be formation of free radicals first. So that's why, first of all, free radical, which can be considered as the R dot, so that can be formed first. So just that free radical is formed by such type of a RCOO, COCOR, like this, which is a alkyl peroxide. So when this alkyl peroxide, which is having this R, which may be the alkyl group, so that R is required for the initiation of this reaction, and for that, so this particular alkyl peroxide is considered. And when this alkyl peroxide undergoes reaction by two different ways, either by the decomposition, whenever decomposition is carried out, there is the formation of a such type of RCOO free radical, like that, twice. While whenever there is a directly dissociation occurs, here there is a formation of twice R free radical plus CO2. So here twice CO2, like this. So ultimately what we want? We want R free radical. So for that, these different processes are there. So after this formation of a twice RCOO, at last we can get a free radical, that is the R free radical. So this R free radical is our initiator, which we have to consider to start the reaction. So this is the first step of the initiation. Now we will see the second step of initiation, and we wrote this as a A. So second is a B. So we'll write this B here. So here there is a formation of already free radical occurs. So this R free radical is a main initiator of our reaction. Now we can consider any molecule as a M, etc. Or we can consider the ethylene molecule. So we'll consider here both type, both ways to carry out the mechanism. Just consider this M. M is a particular monomer. And here we can again consider CH2 double bond CH2. It is the very first molecule which is there for the process of polymerization. Now here whenever there is a reaction with R free radical plus M, there is a formation of M free radical 1. It is shown that M free radical 1. Why? When we see example, actually here this free radical, when it will approach towards the very first carbon, what will happen? Here there is a breaking of bond occurs and formation of free radical on this both carbon occurs. While this free radical from this carbon and this free radical, there is a formation of a single bond in between R and CH2. So in this way there is a formation of R bond CH2, while this double bond is converted into now single bond. So this single bond is there, CH2 is there and free radical is there as it is on this particular carbon. So in this way, this is the very first initiator which is formed by the process of initiation. So initiation in this way is carried out by two different ways. First, the alkyl peroxide undergoes the process of dissociation and decomposition, either by dissociation or by decomposition. And at last we can get here the toluene R dot, which is a free radical, and that toys R dot which is called as an initiator also or free radical, when approaches towards the very first molecule of ethylene, there is a formation of a first initiator. So this is a single initiator, while if we see the example of ethylene, there is a formation of R CH2 CH2 free radical, which is a very first initiator. In this way, initiation step carried out. Now, this initiator is now ready to accept a number of ethylene molecules, similar type of molecules. So, that process is called as a propagation. Now, here it completes the initiation step. Now, second step is of propagation that we will see. So, in this propagation step particularly, there is the addition of such a similar type of molecules. So, second is a propagation. We will write it once again. Propagation. In this propagation, as I already told that at first there is a formation of M1 free radical. If we see the example of monomer as a M, there is the addition of another M. So in this way we can get M free radical 2 like this. So again there is the addition of M. Again we can get M free radical 3 like this. So if again n number of M are added, so there may be formation of like this M free radical N like this. So we can easily understand from this particular example. Now another by the example way. So what was our initiator? R CH2 CH2 free radical. So now it is ready to accept number of ethylene molecules. So we can write here N CH2 CH2, that is ethylene molecule, which is in N number. So here again in every molecule there occurs the breaking of this bond, pi bond from this both, and formation of a bond between this CH2 free radical and this particular very first CH2 molecule. As there is a no any another group or heteroatom which is attached to the carbon, there is no problem, and simply there is a formation of free radical is going on continuously. And we can get a large bulky free radical at last. So in this way, how can we write this R into CH2, R bond CH2, CH2. This free radical now forms the bond with this free radical of this carbon when this bond will be broken. So in this way, we can write like this CH2, CH2 again bond is there. So bond, we can write here bond also as well as this free radical also. But these are in number N. So we can write CH2 CH2 by N like this. So in this way, this is a product of propagation step, which is like this. So it is a M free radical dot N. M free radical N like this. So in this way, RCH2CH2 by NCH2CH2 free radical is formed. Now this is a last product of propagation. Here we can add number of similar type of molecules again. Till we stop this particular reaction, it will not be stopped. So we have to carry out its termination. The third is the step of termination.